prayer time in our midst, and I know that Marshall had a reminder for me, and I remember it's prayer time. We want to invite those of you who desire to come down to this altar during the season of prayer and thanksgiving and intercession. We invite those of you who desire to come to do so as we lift up members who have called in this week and ask that their names be called out today for prayer. We are believing God, touching and agreeing not only with them, but with each of you in this very, very space. If you desire to remain in your seat, we just ask that you would know the name of the person who's sitting next to you so that we might be able to call their name in prayer as well. We're praying for the Kinsey family. Again, we're praying for Don Purnell and her entire family, Deacon Parker and family. Pray for Brother William Patton, whose birthday is being celebrated today, and we pray for continued to Lystra Wins, Evelyn and Mary Moore and family. We're lifting up Mother Bernita Pearson and the Pearson family, Dr. Mitch Melson and Orpha Richard. We continue to pray for Dimple Winfrey and Bernice and Cordell Reed, Ernestine Gilliam and Samantha Lexi White. We call these names sincerely as we pray for McLean Graham and Christine Skate, Johnny Halton and Willie Mae Cook, and Francia Green and Coley Bryant and David Pearson. We pray for the Robinson family and the Thomas family, and we pray for you in this very, very room. Today I'm going to be praying for Reverend Pearson, who will be having surgery on next Monday. Pastor is in need of a major break, and so I'm going to not be here, but I'm going to believe God with him as he prepares to go next Monday to receive this procedure, and our God is yet able. So as I pray for him, I'm praying for each and every one of you in this space. Amen. Amen. I'm going to ask you to kneel. Amen. Our Father, and you are our God. We enter into your gates with thanksgiving and into your courts with praise. And you said, be thankful unto me and bless your name. So God, we thank you right now for another day. And we thank you, God, because we know that you are yet a healer and a restorer. And so, God, as we touch and agree with Reverend Pearson, we ask, God, right now that you will prepare the mind and even the body for full restoration, for full healing, God. And we believe you, O God, for a testimony that is aligned with the power of the resurrection. So we give you thanks in advance that all is well. We thank you in advance, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus. And God, as we pray for him and anoint him, O God, we pray and lift up every person that has called in on this week, every person that's under the sound of my voice. God, we stand here and we kneel here and we're sitting in this work of ministry, knowing, God, that you are still able to do exceedingly, abundantly above all that we can ask or even think. God, we give you glory and we give you honor. We bring every care, we bring every situation, we bring every circumstance, every prayer need, every prayer request, every hurt, every question, every doubt. We lay them on the altar right now in the name of Jesus. And God, we believe that you're going to work it out for our good, because we love you and we are the called according to your purpose. God, we may not see it, we may not feel it, but God, by faith it is so, and so it is. So God, with everything we've got left in our bodies, we give you glory and we give you honor. We give you praise. We give you the glory and the We give you the praise. God, work it out. See it through. Be a wedge all around us, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you for rebuking, oh God, and releasing every stronghold in our mind, in our bodies, oh God. And God, we thank you right now that you're giving comfort to the comfort, oh God. You're giving comfort, oh God, to those who are bereaved. You're giving peace beyond our understanding. Bless us today, God. Pour it out in the name of Jesus. And God, we'll be mindful to give your name the praise and the glory. But right now, we give you a praise by faith in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Everybody on the phone say it in Jesus' name. And the church of God said amen, amen, and amen. It is so. And so it is. Come on, put those hands together. No. Don't praise him like he's already doing it. Oh, no, praise him like he's doing it. He's doing it, and not only like he's doing it, he is doing it. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
believers in the house to know He is alive? Isn't that why we're here? Isn't that why we came this morning? Because He is alive. Anybody really know it for yourself? He's really alive. Somebody give Him the best praise that you have. Give Him the best praise that you have. Give Him the best praise that you have. Hallelujah. Give us ears to hear and hearts to receive in Jesus' name for your glory and your honor. Amen and amen. And the church of God said, amen. Want to share with you, I know that we have some special folk in the house who come and to celebrate, and people sometimes tease folk about only coming on certain days of the year. Some people tease folk about, you know, being a CME kind of person, coming on Christmas and Mother's Day and Easter. I'm not going to tease you, because I recognize that you recognize that there's something powerful about this day. And if there were a choice of when you would come, this, for me, would be the choice I would make with you and for you. Because if there is no resurrection, there is no hope. And if there is no resurrection, according to the text this morning, our preaching, our singing, our coming is in vain. Paul said in his word that if there is no resurrection, then our faith is in vain. So the reason why we get dressed up, the reason why we make this day a very special day, because this is the day of all days that we as believers can proclaim that our God is not a dead God, but He is alive and He is well, because He's living on the inside of us. If there's any day that belongs to only the believers, it's the Resurrection Sunday. Hallelujah, somebody. I know that some of us may be weary in our bodies, some may be weary in our minds, some may be weary because we've been here since 5 a.m., but God is still giving us the strength and the ability, because when we think about what God did on the Calvary cross, when we think about what Jesus did for us and why He went through what He went through, it gives us energy to lift our hands, it gives us energy to lift our voices, it gives us the energy to stand and give Him glory. Because if it had not been for the cross, if it had not been for the shed blood on Calvary, we wouldn't be here right now. If it had not been for Him looking beyond our faults and seeing our needs, we wouldn't have a hope, we wouldn't have a testimony, we wouldn't have a song, we wouldn't have a shout, we wouldn't have a praise. Thank God for the blessings of the resurrection. Nobody can own this day but the believer. Nobody can own this day. There are folk right now who are getting drunk because it's Easter. I got you. It's another holiday for you. Having dinners. I got you. It's another gathering for you. But the reason why we're celebrating and we're fellowshipping also, but the real reason why we're here is because God so loved us. I just need a little help. That He gave His only begotten Son. That whosoever believeth in Him would not perish, but have everlasting. 19 verse that says God did not send his son into the world to condemn us. But through his what? Son. He gives us what?
Salvation.
My brothers and sisters, today is a day of celebration because of what God did. Yeah. But then not only what God did, but what his son did.
Yeah. Yes, God.
While we were yet, he died. Yeah. They found no fault in him. Yeah. But he died. Yeah. But before he died, they took him through a process to make sure that he was embarrassed, associated with thieves. You know how it is. Folk don't mind tearing you down. And when you're down, they want you to come lower. But how many of you know that the lower I go, the higher the glory? Yeah. Some of y'all been through some stuff. And you people have counted you out. In fact, they told you that your story just ended. When Jesus was on his way to the cross, the folk around him thought his story was going to be ended. But they did not know that God has the last word of a chapter of your story. Some things that you've been going through and the things that you are in the midst of right now. I'm here to encourage somebody. In spite of what you're going through, God has the final word. But look at what this day is all about. Here he is. Jesus, the Son of God, went to the cross because a sacrificial lamb had to be offered. And the only lamb was the Lamb of God. Somebody say, thank you for the Lamb of God. Not only did they crucify him with words and spit on him and talked about him and slain him while he was on the road, on his way to the cross, he could have stopped. And that's what the seven last words are all about. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. He was thirsty in his flesh, and they gave him some bitter, vinegar, not herb, vinegar, like some cheap wine. You go to somebody's house, hello somebody, dinner's all spread out. You know, the table is all set. The good china is all out. Are you with me? How the food is smelling good in the house. The aroma is good. And then you're looking around. People have wine glasses on their table and put juice in them. You know how that goes. Because y'all saved and sanctified. But you like the look of it. Yeah, yeah. But then those who really like the real grapes, you go to somebody and they got some bad stuff. You know, the stuff they have, the stuff all at the bottom, and you got to, you know, shake it up and, you know. Oh, I know y'all saved and y'all been delivered. I've not been delivered from the real grapes yet, so y'all pray my strength in the Lord. Jesus was thirsty. You know, oh, brothers, you, it's warm and you looking for a cold one. Okay. You know, and I mean, it's warm and you look for a cold one. And somebody goes into the trunk and pull out. What am I going to do with this? Take it 10 degrees higher. That's where Jesus was in the heat of the day. Thirsty. Then he was concerned about his mother. Can you imagine your mother watching you go through? Can you imagine how that would feel, sitting there and listening to all of the trash being spoken about her only son, or one of her sons? He went to the cross, and then when they put the
crown. See, since you're the King of Kings, we put the crown of thorns. Well, they can just lay the crown of thorns on his head. When they put the crown of thorns on his head, they press in to his skull. And the blood came streaming down. Don't sing these songs if you don't have the collection and the recollection of what really happened. The blood came streaming down. But he did it in obedience to his Father. And because of the obedience of his Father, we stand here as the recipients that there is still power in the blood of the Lamb. We stand here as recipients that what he did 2,000 years ago gives us the ability to face our tomorrow. That's why the songwriter says, because he lives, I can do what? And because he lives, all fear is what? Because I know who holds tomorrow. And we know who holds our hand. Look. You know, when Paul is in his text of the 14th through the 18th, the 19th verses, and he's talking about if Christ wasn't dead, then our preaching is in vain. He said if he was dead, then our praying and our faith is in vain. But then he always ends up at the end of those texts and said, but because Christ has been raised, there are no more false witnesses. And I said this morning, there are some witnesses in this room right now who can testify that God is still God. No, I must be in the wrong place. But I believe there may be two or three people right in that section over there that know that God is still God. No, that must be the wrong section over there. But there may be two or maybe four people over here that know that God is still. He's still God and he's still able. Is there any witnesses in this section that know that God can make a way out of no way? Anybody in this section that know that God is still a deliverer? He's still a provider. Oh, y'all sit down. Y'all trying to act like you know. Is there anybody over here that knows that he is Lord of Lords, King of Kings? Anybody? And because we know, we are the witnesses that God is calling for in this day to let people know that God is still alive and he's still a God of power and authority. And we don't have to fear, because God has not given us a spirit of fear, but he's given us power, he's given us love, he's given us a sound mind. So there's a blessing in the resurrection. So Pastor, as you close and take your seat, because I've got a brunch to go to, tell me, what's my blessing? The blessing is, if you die in the Lord, it ain't over. The blessing is, there's nothing you can do that will separate you from the love of God in Christ Jesus. The blessing is that God is able to deliver you and make you free. The blessing is that he's still a way maker and a door opener. The blessing is that God one day is coming back to receive us unto... I sit down, Pastor. The blessing is I'm going through, but I'm coming out. And when I come out, I'm coming out bigger, better, greater, because of the resurrection. sit down for a minute. Check it out. Go to the place where Moses was buried. His remains are still there. Go to the place where Buddha is acknowledged. His remains are still there. Go to the place where they buried David. His remains are still there. I can go down the list and the bodies or the remains are still there. But you go to Jerusalem. And you go to the place where they laid his body. Hallelujah, somebody. Hallelujah, somebody. And there is nobody. You go there right now, and above his grave site, it says he's not here. He's alive. And my brothers and sisters, that gives us hope to know that there is nothing too difficult for God to do. The only thing we've got to do is rejoice while we're going through it. Rejoice while you're in it. Hold on to the faith to know that this resurrection power is not dead, but it's still alive. I've got to close here because my body is shutting down. But I'm here to tell somebody, don't you worry. Don't you fret. Don't you give in. The same God that put his son on the cross and allowed him the power to get up, that same God. So anybody want a resurrection touch? Anybody want a resurrection feel? Anybody want a resurrection anointing? Well, you know what? It's like this. I can't give it to you. You've got to receive it for yourself. There's not enough oil in the jar. You've got to receive it for yourself. You ask me how I know he lives. Because he lives inside of me. Sometimes, I got to close y'all, but sometimes it gets so exciting of the things that go on the inside of us. Because he lives, that we cannot hold our peace. Sometimes tears will come down our faces and we're not sad. Sometimes we feel like running and nobody is chasing us. Sometimes we'll shout a hallelujah and nobody has asked us. Because he lives, there is nothing too hard for him or impossible for you to go through. So there are blessings all around us because of the resurrection. Look around you, look around you, look around you, look around you. Look blessed, 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 blessed. Bless, 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 bless. No, 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 no. See, y'all pretending. No, bless, bless. But no, no, for real, y'all playing. I mean, bless, bless. I mean, for real, bless, bless. I mean, for real, bless, bless, so blessed that no weapon that's formed against you shall prosper. And every tongue that rises against you in judgment shall condemn. Why? Because I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, what? Though he were what?
Live.
Yes, shall he what?
Live.
Tell somebody, live.
Live.
Tell somebody else, say live.
Live.
You all, I understand what it means to preach through the storm. And I wouldn't stand here today. Do you hear me?
if I did not believe in the power of his resurrection, I would have skipped 6 o'clock service. I would have skipped 10:30 service. I would not have participated in the Holy Week services. If I didn't believe that there's more to this story than what we're living through right now, I would have closed the book and I would have exited. But because he has proven himself over now, I know I'm the only one. And when you think your back is against the wall, he's proven himself. New mercies, new grace, every day. And your pastor stands here as a witness that there are blessings in the power of his resurrection. Hallelujah, somebody. Everyone standing to your feet. 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 There are gifts of this resurrection. And I want to extend an invitation first to those in this space who say, Pastor, I need to accept the Lord as my Savior, because I need this assurance of hope and I desire the gifts of the power of the resurrection. If you're here, I want you to find the nearest aisle. I want you to come and give your life to God by accepting his son Jesus Christ. We had a member, a young lady this morning, after the Sunday school program, accepted the Lord Jesus as her personal Savior. Hallelujah to the King. If you're here, say, Pastor, I'm already a believer, but I want to join this ministry. I want you to come. Come right now. Come and give your life and your commitment unto the Lord. If you're here, the doors of the church are open as we sing. If there's one, don't wait. Don't hesitate. Don't wait. Don't hesitate. Everyone in the space, we offer Christ. If I were you, I would not let this opportunity pass on this Resurrection Sunday. You're here and you know you want to make that commitment. You're longing to make that commitment. Don't wait. This is the day. This is the time. If you're afraid to walk alone, just slip up your hand and somebody will come and walk with you to affirm that his grace and his love is there for us. Is there somebody else? Don't wait. Don't wait. Oh, come.